Doc Watson passed away yesterday at Wake Forest Baptist Medical Center at the age of 89.
In a career that took him from the mountains of North Carolina to Carnegie Hall and beyond, his legacy will live on through the music and style that was all his own. Doc Watson was born in Deep Gap, North Carolina in 1923 into a family already rich in musical tradition. Blind from an eye infection before his first birthday, the banjo was Doc's first instrument, but as a teenager, he took up the guitar, and the rest is history. He blended his traditional Appalachian roots with bluegrass, country, gospel, and blues to create a unique style, and he soon became the gold standard among traditional pickers. Doc recorded more than 50 albums and collaborated with other legends like Flatten Scruggs, Chet Atkins, and of course his own son, Merle. Merle died in a tractor accident in 1985, and 3 years later, Doc started Merlefest in his honor. It's an annual gathering of musicians that draws tens of thousands to Wilkes Community College and is now that school's primary fundraising event. And nowhere is Doc Watson's loss felt greater than on that campus today, where flags fly at half staff.
It was supposed to be a one-time concert to benefit the Gardens of the Census here at the college. So I don't think anyone could see what it would become. But I think that shows a lot of the people's feelings about Doc, the man he was, the musician he was. There's a great love for that man.
To hear Doc do those fiddle tunes was just absolutely amazing thing to me.
Musician Wayne Henderson was a good friend of Doc's. His daughter was making a guitar that she was going to present to Doc Watson in 2 weeks. Henderson says Watson virtually invented the art of playing mountain fiddle tunes on a flat-top guitar.
His influence in the world of folk music will ever be forgotten, and because he had such a huge impact on everybody. Everybody from, you know, the parking lot picker like me to presidents. And knows who Doc Watson was and was fascinated with his style of playing music.
In 2011, a life-size statue was unveiled in Boone on the same spot where decades earlier the young Doc Watson had played for tips to support his family. At his own request, the inscription reads, "Just one of the people." His fans agree.
He wasn't a presumptuous celebrity. And he contributed so much to the community. If there was a fundraiser, he was playing.
When you think of Doc, you think of folk music, mountain music. And I think that Doc will last forever.
Doc Watson was the recipient of the National Medal of Arts, a National Heritage Fellowship, and he won 8 Grammy Awards, including one for Lifetime Achievement.